Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We will resume the session again. This coming session is, I would say, the most interesting of all what we have, because we will present interesting cases. In fact, the cases will be presented by our team, Dr. Shagran, who's a rising star in our department and responsible for fellowship training. With him, there will be Dr. Amr Sa'dani. Many of you know him, and he was very fundamental part of the program from the start. And also Dr. Samuel Ashwal and Dr. Ahmed Hayden. Both are really also not only stars, but shining suns in the department. So the cases will be, these are some of them from your own centers. How we dealt with them, what are the results, and so on. And it's a chance for us to discuss together after that how you assess these patients and how you perceive our results on the ground after they leave us. So I'll leave you first with Dr. Samuel Ashwal to present some of the cases and then the rest of the team.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ala, and thank you for coming. I'll present two cases from our referral cases. First case is a 60 years old lady in a case of diabetes and hypertension and end stage renal disease on hemodialysis, presented with bilateral portal claudication more on the left side and left big toe ulcer. So this is her baseline Doppler study. We can see there is left common iliac artery stenosis. This is the stenotic area. And this is the waveform, which is damped and monophasic waveform. And this is also distal to the stenosis. Common femoral artery also monophasic. SFA also have abnormal waveform. Popliteal as well. Posterior tibial. Distal posterior tibial, anterior tibial proximally, distally, and dorsal pedis. This is the right side because she is complaining of bilateral, but we can see the right side is normal. This is right obliteal. So the angiogram was done. We went from the right side and we did the first run at the pelvic area, and we see this very tight stenosis of the common iliac artery, which is corresponding to the Doppler findings. We cross from, we have access from the same side and cross the lesion with the wire. Then straight away we bought a balloon-mounted stent. This is the stent. We can see there is some still stenosis in the stent here without bone. And we dilate again with the balloon, 8 millimeter balloon in the stent area. And this is post angioplasty of the stent, which show the improvement of the flow and opening of the stenosis. This is the finding in the SFA. We can see multiple stenotic areas. Patient has previous fracture and this fixation. Also here, there is stenosis and occlusion of the popliteal artery. ETE, we can just faint seeing the contrast. Posterior tibial is not seen. This is the anterior tibial. Here, only anterior tibial artery, which is not enough for the foot, and this collaterals. This is with bone. This is the foot. We can see the branches of the tarsal arteries in the foot, and this is to the big toe. This is with bone, and this is in lateral view. We can see the anterior tibial, mainly from the anterior tibial artery, the foot get sublime. So the angioplasty started from the SFA popliteal and anterior tibial artery to increase the flow. And this is post-angioplasty, then down to the anterior tibial artery, 2 millimeter balloons, trying to open the distal branches. 2 millimeter balloon as well. So this is the anterior tibial artery with the wire inside, distally to the tarsal branches. Continue dilatation. Here we can see there is stenosis here. This is with bone. And the balloon now is down, dilating. Actually, this case was done by Prof. Marco Manzi. He's from Italy. He came in from time to time to do these cases, and he is expert in angiosome and foot angioplasty. So he crossed the posterior tibial artery down here, and when he did the run, there is some branches, collaterals. He did angioplasty with 2 millimeter balloon, also along the posterior tibial artery, up to here. And continue to the SFA. This is post-angioplasty. It is improving with minimal residual stenosis, which is not significant. Now the popliteal is open, we can see. When we compare to the initial image, it is open. Anterior tibial artery is more regular now. The posterior tibial artery, we can see, this is due to the fixation of the tibia.
Artifact.
Yeah, this is artifact, not necessary. This is the area. And here is the arteries open. And it got some supply from the posterior tibia. So the patient came, this is the initial, and this is the follow-up Doppler study. We can see the difference in the common femoral artery. And this is the initial in the SFA before angio, and this is the follow-up. It is by biphasic waveform. And also posterior tibial before angio. And now, after angio, it is more spiking and better. Follow-up on May 2015, so 1 year, the last follow-up for this patient, the patient clinically improved, and the resolved claudication and the ulcer was healed. This patient was referred from Hafr al-Batn by Dr. Karrar on 2014. Case number two is 71 years old male from Buraida, diabetes and hypertension, presented with left big toe ulcer. So the angiogram from the other side was done. And we notice very tight stenosis at the origin of the superficial femoral artery. And also here in the profundo. Angioplasty done on the proximal SFA by 5 millimeter by 4 cm balloon, and also for the profunda artery. Post angioplasty show this dissection, so it was decided to put a stent there. So putting the stent at the proximal and to keep the profunda open. Now post stenting, there is no more dissection, and there is good flow of blood. Here below knee, we found this is stenosis, also stenosis of the anterior tibial artery. dilatation with 5 millimeter balloon at the popliteal area. This is the posterior tibial artery, dilated with 2 millimeter balloon. We notice here there is no continuation of blood flow. And also this is the frontal image for the same, for this lateral image. So it was tried to cross all this area. So this is the initiation to the artery supply in the big toe. So we dilate here with the balloon, and also the balloon reach up to the big toe, 1.5 millimeter barrel. Also back, going back to the artery here. Also back, dilatation back here to the main artery. This is also a continuation of angioplasty. So this is higher up and dilatation with 5 millimeter balloon. So we can see this artery is already open in comparing with the initial image to its distal, and improve the supply to the foot. And so this one, you can see this is the supply to the distal. So this was two examples of the cases, and I show them because we, of the dilatation and angioplasty of the small arteries in the foot itself, not only the main supply of the foot. Any comment or?
The question is how long it will survive those distal small arteries?
According to the follow-up, clinical follow-up, the are improving, and the one here. And because this case is just done on March, and the patient is improving, and we are using very small balloon, which is 1.5 millimeter.
I mean, the aim usually you want to deal with the ulcer and to heal it. Of course, maybe the arteries will occlude later, could be, but without the ulcer. So at least we gain time, and then we deal with the problem later. But some of them will find them still patent years later, but you can't predict. But this is, of course, a new technique. I mean, when I started my training, we were happy to open SFA, and we are very pleased. And then we went back down to the anterior
one artery. Yeah.
Now, as you see from this, this is a new thing, going even to the intertarsal arteries. This is really a new adventure. And alhamdulillah, here we started to do that more and more. As Sami said,
The pioneer in this is an Italian professor, or Dr. Menzi, and he really regularly comes here. We hope, by the way, to invite him in the next workshop. There is some talk about it in October. He may also present his experience, so that will enrich our experience. Anyway, next presenter is Ahmed Hedib. Of course, he is one of our best fellows, and now he is assistant consultant. And hopefully, very soon he will be a consultant with us here. Again, you can see, I mean, the main message really that it's not one person or two persons. The whole team within the interventional radiology who are really interested in this and to improve it.
I will present a couple of two cases, continue what Dr. Samuel presented. We have a 75 years old female patient, known case of diabetes, referred to our service as a case of left lower limbs. Critical ischemia presented with left big toe gangrene and wrist pain. On examination, strong bilateral femoral pulses, audible bilateral dorsal pedis, posterior tibial artes by Doppler, gangrenous forefoot. On investigation, WBC is normal as well, platelet and INR and GFR. As you see here, we have on the ABI and the PVR study, we have abnormal bilateral lower limb indices more in the left side, critically on the below the knee with abnormal waveforms below the knee at the leg and the ankle here. An ultrasound, the left atrium femoral artery Doppler showed a biphasic waveform, ours patent. The proximal SFA shows abnormal waveform with very sluggish flow on the 22 centimeter per second, with further slowdown of the flow, with significant reconstitution of the flow at the distal SFA, as well as the popliteal artery. The posterior tibial and the anterior tibial arteries are patent with good waveforms. Then we proceeded with the with an angiogram starting from the right side with a retrograde femoral puncture, 5-French sheath, placing the catheter at the lower abdominal aorta. Angiogram was done, showed mildly abnormal bilateral common iliac arteries, and the flow was good, confirmed by the angulation of the tube, and if you see here, however, it's patent. And, further down, we have a total occlusion of the left superficial femoral artery, with and as well as the right, is patent with multiple stenotic segments. Further below, we have bilateral patent popliteal arteries. Posterior tibial and peroneal arteries are widely patent. The anterior tibial proximally are not visualized. Then, in the process of trying to cross the left total, the long occlusion, we tried from an anti-grade fashion several attempts trying to cross. We couldn't. Finally, we tried to puncture the distal SFA from down in a retrograde fashion, and we went subintimally. Here we try to join the two segments. With a small wire. And it was unfortunately unsuccessful. We went back, we used a special device to regain the track, called an outback device, and successfully was regained. And we snared the wire from the contralateral side. And the wire was pulled out from the right femoral artery sheath. Then we advanced a micro catheter and wire from above. to try to link the whole SFA together. And it was successful. Then we came back with a, started with three long millimeter balloon throughout the SFA occlusion. This is the initial run post angioplasty. It showed the patent artery with a flow, but this is multiple non-flow limiting dissections. Then we decided at the end to stent the whole occlusion and still remaining the proximal dissection. Stented, this is a final run which showed brisk flow with. At the end, hemostasis is achieved by angioseal closure device. Patient kept in, under our observation for 4 hours. Aspirin Plavix were prescribed for the patient before discharge. On her follow-up, patient significantly improved, wrist pain improved, as well as the wound. We'll present another case. This is an 82 years old male patient, known case of diabetes, hypertension, ischemic heart disease, as well referred to our service as a case of left lower limb critical ischemia, presented left big toe gangrene. Strong on examination, strong bilateral pulses, audible dorsalis pedis artery by Doppler, dry gangrene of the left big toe. Investigation. WBC is normal, as well as the platelet and the coagulation profile and renal profile. Initial angiogram was done from the right common femoral artery in a retrograde fashion, which showed patent bilateral common iliac arteries as well as the external and femoral arteries. Further down, patent bilateral superficial femoral arteries with mild stenotic segments, however, it's brisk, with brisk flow. Distally at the popliteal artery showed a reasonably long occlusion with single bilonia runoff to the anterior tibial artery. Posterior tibial and peroneal arteries are occluded. The occlusion was successfully crossed, and initially we started with a 4 millimeter balloon. Post balloon dilatation, the left side showed the channel was open, but the flow started not brisk with multiple dissections. Went back again with 5 millimeter balloon. There is improvement of the flow, but still dissections are there. Then we decided to place a supra stent across the popliteal artery. This is the post stenting. So the brisk flow throughout the occluded segment. Then we went down to improve the outflow vessel. The tibial peroneal trunk was dilated with a 3 millimeter balloon. The posterior tibia was successfully crossed and dilated with 2 millimeter balloon. This is a final with a patent popliteal posterior tibial with good flow to the foot. Again, post procedure, we close the puncture site with a stark closure device. Patient usually kept in our department for 4 hours. And aspirin and Plavix were prescribed. Follow up in 3 months, and patient came with good brisk flow supra stent with ultrasound and clinically improved the wound as well. Thank you.